This video is going to be about finding the area and perimeter of rectangles, squares, and triangles. So let's start with some definitions. A rectangle is a four-sided figure, and each of the corners is a right angle, just like the corners on a piece of paper or the corners of a window or most rooms. And we can think of the dimensions of the rectangle as the width and the length. The perimeter of a rectangle is just the area, the distance, all the way around. So in other words, if you start in one corner, go all the way around the outside of the rectangle, come back to where you started, that's going to be the perimeter. So we can figure out the perimeter of a rectangle pretty easily. We're doing one of the widths. Let's say we start here, going over to here. Then we do a length. Then we do another width, and then we come back and do another length. So we've got two widths and two lengths. So the perimeter is going to be 2w plus 2l. And if you want to, you could think of this as also the perimeter is 2 times w plus l, since if we distribute this 2 to the w and the l, we'll get right back to 2w plus 2l. A square is just a special rectangle. A square also has four sides. Each of the corners is a right angle. The only difference is that for a square, all the sides are exactly the same. So we can think of this as a side, a side, a side, and a side. And if I walk all the way around, I'll have four sides. So the perimeter for a square, perimeter, let's put a little square down here. The perimeter of a square is just going to be 4s. For triangles, so a triangle is any three-sided figure, and the sides can be different lengths. So basically the perimeter of a triangle is going to be, let's call the sides A, B, and C. It's just going to be A plus B plus C. If I had a five-sided figure, I would add up five sides and get the perimeter of that figure. Okay, so that's basically it for triangles. Let's go into area. So starting with a rectangle, you remember the rectangle's two dimensions are length and width. The area is everything, the surface, everything inside the rectangle. To find that area, we multiply the length and the width together. So the area is going to be, the area is going to be the length times the width. If I want the area of a square, you remember all the sides are the same. So if I multiplied a side times a side, like thinking multiplying a width times a length, then that would just be side squared or s squared. So the area of a square, put a little square in again, is going to be just s squared. Let's look at triangles. So one way to think about a triangle is that a triangle might be one half of a rectangle. Now remember, the rectangle, the area of the rectangle, was the width times the length. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change what I call this. For a triangle, we usually call the bottom of the triangle the base. And we call the height of the triangle, this makes sense, the height. So if I wanted to find the area of a triangle, it would be one half of the area of the rectangle that I had. Remember, I'm using h and b, or height and base, instead of length and width. So the area of this triangle, in other words, just this part, is going to be the area of a triangle is going to be the base times the height, like the length times the width, divided by 2. And that's going to work for any triangle, as long as I know what its base and its height is. So in other words, if I've got a triangle that's shaped like this, and I'm given its base, and usually they'll show something like this, and they'll give the height. Let's say this was that the base equaled 5, and the height was 4. I'm just going to take my formula, area equals base times height over 2. So area equals base times height over 2. Plug my two numbers in. I'll get the area equals 5 times 4. Let's see if I can fit this in. Over 2, 5 times 4 is 20, and 20 divided by 2 is 10. So the area would be 10. And that's all there is to it. Make sure you've got these formulas memorized, and you should be fine. Take care. I'll see you next time.